The word Leeds. We are Larry and Paul, and it is time now to hear our catch-up with the boys from Brighouse, Embrace. They are back after a seven-year hiatus in a candid interview described by them as their best ever.
Yes.
Danny and Mickey from the band talk about their new single, Follow You Home, also making an appearance in our chat, Ferrero Rocher, selling out tour dates, and the drummer, Mike Heaton, covered in chocolate. It's Embrace, everybody.
Yeah!
Not even joking.
Oh, they're here.
Thank you.
I'd love to be able to touch them, but Embrace is speaking to us from a studio in... Are you in London?
We are in lovely London.
Why?
It's a bit drizzly, but it's still lovely.
How weird is that? We got on a train from Leeds this morning to go to London to do an interview with you in Leeds.
Why didn't you just come in?
We've done like 15 interviews today, whereas if we'd come to every single one, we'd have had to go really fast. You'd have had to get us in a helicopter or something.
Yeah, but I mean, we're worth it, aren't we? Just come to us.
Oh, everyone.
Hey, we could come in on another day and spend longer.
If you would, that would be lovely.
Yeah, right. You have to get me a helicopter, right. Though.
Yeah. Why are you so obsessed with a helicopter? Do you want a helicopter?
I've just got a beam up on about having a helicopter. And I want a bag of Tankfastics as well.
Oh, I don't ask for much.
No. He won't leave the house without a bag of sours.
Is that a Haribo brand?
Yeah. It is.
No, you're all about the West Yorkshire, aren't you?
Are they a West Yorkshire company, yeah. Haribo?
Are they?
You're joking.
I never even knew that.
And I never knew. You're kidding.
Are they from Ponty?
Pontefract is their UK headquarters.
Yeah, but they're not from there, surely.
Well, I don't know. They're building another factory in Castleford. This is the truth. But I think they might be Dutch.
Oh, right. I imagined it was from Wisconsin or somewhere.
Wisconsin, yeah. Some like Cleveland, Ohio, some sort of Midwest.
Yeah. That's it, yeah.
Somewhere with a lot of pigs to melt down.
Children and adults love it, so...
Melt the pigs!
Someone melt your pigs!
Melt the pigs! Oh, come on, we gotta make the handle fast enough to melt the pigs, please. Dutch company, melt pigs, will you? Stop standing there, will you, Sven?
Sven's Swedish, I don't know what's going on. He's an immigrant.
He's a new employee.
Oh, God.
Right then, well, nice to hear from you. And,
you as well.
And lovely to have you back, because you did a secret gig in Homeford.
Home Firth of all places. Home of Nora Batty.
Yeah, when we do secret gigs, at the moment they tend to be up north. So, if you know listeners are clever and they go on secretgig.com, they might be in with a chance of getting to the next one.
Well, I think we got an invite to one, didn't we, Paul? And
we
it was
did.
Terrible, but I literally just had a baby.
Really?
Yeah.
How are you feeling?
The first man to have a baby.
Yeah. English man to have a baby, and it meant that I couldn't make the gig, unfortunately.
But by proxy, if he can't come, I can't go, because it's and Paul.
Yeah,
I can't go to anything that he can't attend.
You need to find an auxiliary Larry. I think.
I need a proxy Larry.
Yeah,
a Larry replacement service. Your own PR for your new tour, which we'll get onto in a second. But it says that riding high, you disappeared without a trace. Back in the mid-2000s. But of course you didn't. I mean, you were all involved in different stuff. I mean, Mickey, you were Talk to Angels. You were very busy with those guys.
Yeah, I didn't stop, actually, for a while with that. And then Rick from Embrace sort of got in touch and said, hello, I've written some songs and we should get together and play them and see how it sounds.
And you didn't go entirely dark, because Mike Heaton, he was all over the shop. We saw him all over.
Well, he's an ambassador. He's actually the patron saint of... What is he the patron saint
Ambassadors.
Of? Ambassadors, yeah.
But does he have a pyramid of Ferrero Rocher, is all ambassadors have to have?
Do you know?
He actually
We're going to build him, you know, he's got a drum riser, but we're going to try and concoct that for the tour out of Ferrero Rocher. It's going to be a bit wobbly. Hope we don't turn the lights up too much.
Just drowning in hazelnut and chocolate.
Suffocating on praline.
It looks like a sort of dirty protest on stage, though, all melted, wasn't it? All of you slipping over, covered in unidentified brown sludge.
Well,
again. So, listen, back
are we in the pub or on the radio? I can't quite tell.
We like to think of it as the same thing. But
right.
So you're back with a new album and a new tour. And I was thinking, new tour is quite difficult to gauge sometimes. I guess as a band, you don't always know what the reaction is going to be. But you've already sold out nearly half the tour. That must be a good feeling.
Yeah, it was brilliant.
Promoter said, you know, when they were deciding where they were going to put the tour, they picked all these big venues, and we were like, hang on a minute, we've been away for 8 years, you better hang fire, let's find out, you know, let's do some little ones first. And they're like, oh, no, don't worry.
Now, listen, I don't want us to run short of time here.
Because,
you know, we've got some fun to be had, because Paul's come up with an inventive quiz for you.
Okay.
Embracing your face. a bit like Beat the Intro, but it's not the intro, and it's with your songs, but you're only getting, like, literally the smallest bit ever.
All right, that sounds like fun.
So, given that you went off the grid and went living with Lord Lucan in a Caribbean island for 8 years...
And you actively try to forget your songs.
This might be quite difficult, so...
Okay.
Are you ready with number one?
Yeah. Yes. That's All You Good Good People.
It is All You Good Good People.
Well done, congratulations. Here's number two.
That's Ashes.
Oh, oh, I didn't get that. I thought you wouldn't get like half a bar of guitar.
It is indeed Ashes,
gonna,
well done.
You're going to have to make it harder than this. This is too easy.
Just play even the smaller bit. Just play it even smaller bit.
Right, okay. Okay,
ready?
Right.
Okay, this is number three.
Number three.
I'm hearing lots of trumpets. That sounded like a bit like All You Good Good People again.
It did, didn't it?
We're not that rubbish.
There must know more than one.
Is it Wonder? Is that your final answer?
Yeah.
It's incorrect,
I'm afraid. It's not, no. It is...
Fairly obviously, my weakness is none of your business.
Okay. Yeah, Wonder didn't have any horns on it, but, you know, it's all that sort of... It's all in the same frequency, isn't it?
Wow. Number four, you ready?
Come on! This is your song!
Go on, give us it again.
Okay. Come on, you should know this.
Let's be like Jeremy Pax. Come on.
Come on, you should know this. You should...
Come back to what you know.
Yeah, well,
thanks, guys.
That's all right. And number five.
The final one.
Oh, that's
Wipe Your Eyes, isn't it?
Yeah, it's No Use Crying. Yeah.
No Use Crying. Well done. Congratulations. A round of applause on embracing your face.
3 out of 5.
Yeah, I'm gonna give you 10 out of 10 for that quiz.
Yeah, that was fun.
That was more interesting than the other quizzes.
Thank God for that. How much percentage-wise more interesting than the other quizzes was it? Was we'll use our blurb.
I would go up to the full 100% more interesting than the others.
Our quizzes are 100% more interesting than other local radio stations. Larry, high five.
Embrace. We'll put that on the front of the DVD.
DVD.
Guys, a pleasure to talk to you. We know you've got to move on now, but we look forward to seeing you when you come to Leeds in the middle of May. And if you can come and see us in the studio
it'll be a lot of fun.
We'll definitely ask you all of the questions that we were asked on Twitter to ask you, but don't have the time to ask you now.
Oh, no, can
all
do
right.
it really quickly. Really
can do it really quickly.
Quickly.
Okay.
Come on.
Okay. This one's from Lisa Haycock, and it says, "Why don't you play in Belfast?"
Hopefully before the end of the year, with any luck.
Autumn.
Yeah. Mike says, "Do you plan any Forest gigs this year?"
He's our drummer. He should already know that.
Don't think so.
Okay. Okay. Fiona here says, "Could you ask them if are they back for good, please?"
Yes, we are back for good, definitely.
Ziggy says, "Can you say hello to Graham Feezy?"
Hello, Graham.
Hello, Mr. Feezy.
Tina just says, "High five." It's not really a question.
Somebody called Bush and Associates say, "Thank you for a fab secret gig last night." Also not a question. That's Jane, Tish and Elaine on Twitter.
Oh, lovely. Yeah, beautiful.
And
thank
Ian
you.
Matthews thinks you do your own administration. Where are his tickets for Nottingham?
I think I've put them behind the toaster.
Post. Didn't you stick them in the toaster?
No, I put them behind the toaster for safekeeping, and I burnt the toast, and now the tickets are kind of...
chestnut.
Disaster. Yeah.
The dog's eating them.
Chaps, nice to talk to you. Thanks for joining us, and we'll catch up with you soon.
All right, thank you very much.
Okay, love you. Bye.
Bye.
Love you too.
The lovely chaps from Embrace, Danny and Mickey, joining us for a chat. This is their new single. It's called Follow You Home, and it's out on the 21st of April. The album, self-titled.